guys, welcome back. In this video, I will be talking about loops, one of the most essential elements of programming in general, and specifically in codeless programming. It is something that is present in quite a lot of applications, and you will definitely be running into the necessity to introduce loops in your logic. What is a loop? A loop is a combination of some instructions that you give in your program that needs to be repeated multiple times. Let's come up with some trivial example. Let's say that we are programming a workout, and then in the workout, we will be programming, it will consist of doing some sit-ups and then push-ups and then pull-ups, and then the whole sequence needs to be repeated multiple times. And this is how it can be modeled using a loop. First of all, in the category that says loops, you will see a couple of blocks, and we will go through pretty much all of them except for list, because we haven't talked about lists yet. We'll be coming back to this one. So in here, let's grab this guy right here, put it into our placeholder, and let's say that the entire sequence needs to be repeated 3 times, and it will consist of, let's say, do 10 push-ups, and then do 10 pull-ups, and finally do 10 sit-ups. So this is kind of one set, and then it will be repeated 3 times. So when we run this program, you will see in the output, you see it basically did one set, second set, and the third set. So this sequence was repeated 3 times. And that's exactly what the loop does. So anything inside of our loop block, which is the repeat certain number of times, anything that you put inside of it is going to be repeated this specific number of times. And how many times it needs to be repeated can be either a specific value, as you put it in here, or it could be a variable. If we were to introduce a variable, let's create a variable that is called number of sets, and let's set this variable to, for instance, 5. So if we go to math and set this number to 5, and then use this variable in our block. So now the entire workout will be repeated 5 times. In fact, let's also introduce a new print here and use it kind of as a divider called new set. This way, they will be visually separated. So let's rerun this. And as you can see, it got printed 5 times. So there were 5 sets in this workout, and each set consisted of this specific number of instructions. And that's what the loops are about, is essentially taking that block of logic that needs to be repeated multiple number of times. Let's introduce another example. I'm going to disable this block and also disable the variable. And let's take a look at another type of loop that we have, which is this one, where it goes like this. So count, width, and then there is a variable, and this variable by default, it is I. And as you can see in the variables, now there is a variable I. And then this variable will start with the value 1, and then it will go to the value 10, and it will be incremented by 1 every single time. And inside of this loop, I will add a print block, and I will print out the value of I. In fact, I will compose that value like this. Here I will say value of variable I is, and then we will just bring our variable. And notice that what's going to happen when we run this page. As you can see, the variable I started with 1, and then with every new iteration of the loop, or sometimes it is called step of the loop, it got incremented by 1. Watch what happens if I change this to 2 and rerun this page. You see, we got started with 1, and then every time it was incremented by 2. Notice that the very last step, the iteration of it, was 9. And the reason it got to 9 is because when variable I was 9, that it got incremented by 2 and the value became 11. But the condition of this loop is to go from 1 to 10. So as soon as I became greater than 10, then the loop stopped, basically exited. And then whatever happened at this loop, in this case, nothing, the program stopped execution. So let's do something a little bit more interesting with this type of loop. And in here, we will just print out all the numbers that are, let's say, even, okay? And it will just print out these numbers. And the higher range of that, the higher limit of that range would be determined by a variable. So let's say if we want to print out all the even numbers starting from 1 to, let's say, 100, then that loop will take care of this for us. And for this, we will do the following. First of all, let's declare a new variable. And let's call it high ceiling. And that's going to be the number to where we will go from 1 to that number, basically find all the even numbers. And in here, let's say that we will go from 1 to, let's say, 50. Okay. And then this ceiling variable will go into here. So it will go from 1 to 50 in this case. And let's say that the step is going to be 1, okay? And in this case, what we need to do is to determine if I, and I starts with 1, and it goes and it's incremented by 1, we need to determine if that number is even or odd. And if we go into math, you will see that one of the blocks is remainder of. And then by using remainder of, we can actually determine if the number is odd or even. In fact, if we take variable I and divide it by 2, if the remainder is 0, it means the number is even. If the remainder is 1, it's going to be odd. So in here, if we add a little bit of logic, and we check if the result of this is 0, it means the number is even. And this is how we can check if that is 0. So if we go into logic and take this block and put this in here, and we need to check against 0. So if this condition is true, basically taking current i, dividing it by 2, and then getting the remainder of that division, if it is 0, then the number is going to be even. In fact, let's print this out. Number is even, and then we will take that current number as the variable I. And let's run this page. And as you can see, this logic printed out all the even numbers between 1 and 50 by using this logic. Just to go over it one more time, we set the high ceiling, basically it identified the range, to 50. And then the variable I starts with 1 and it goes to 50 in this case, and it is incremented by 1 every single time. In here, we calculate the remainder of the division of the current variable I, and it goes 1, 2, 3, and so on. We divide it by 2. If the remainder of the division is 0, which happens only with even numbers, then we print out this value. What would be a simpler way to determine even numbers? Well, in this case, we can start with 0, increment it by 2, and in this case, we do not even need to do this check. In fact, the loop will do it for us, because it will start with 0, and then the next value is going to be 2, 4, and so on. So the actual values of I with every new step of this loop are going to be even numbers. And let's run it one more time. And we got exactly the same result. So all these numbers are even numbers. So that's the loop. For instance, sometimes when you are inside of a loop, you need to determine that there is a condition where the loop must stop, okay? For instance, let's say that we have a condition that we want to go through all these even numbers, but as soon as it gets to, let's say, number 33, or if it's whenever greater than 30, for instance, we want to exit this loop. Let's just imagine that there is this condition. How do you go about this in Codeless? In logic, let's add this logic and check if the current value of I is greater than 30. And that's how it will work. So we take current value of I, and here we put greater than number 30. And if that when that condition is true, we just want to exit, break out of that loop. And if you go into loops, you see this break out of loop. And what's going to happen with this condition is true, that loop will stop. So no matter what you put in here into the high ceiling, so long that it's greater than 30, then that condition will get triggered. Let's run this page. There you go. See, it got to 30 while the actual high ceiling is 50. So we know that that if condition is true. In fact, for debugging purposes, you can take a print block and put it in here and say breaking out of the loop. So this way you know that the execution of your logic got to this point. And if you run it here, you will see that the very last line will be breaking out of the loop. Okay? There is also an element called continue with next operation. This is something that can be useful is when you run through the loop, but you don't want the remainder of that block, anything inside of the loop to go. You just want to kind of skip to the next iteration, skip to the next step. This way, if you were to do continue with next iteration of the loop, you will basically saying anything that's down below, ignore it and then start this loop with the next step. So that's what this continue with the next iteration is. I'm sure there will be a couple of lectures where we use that specific function. Okay, there is another form of the loop that that's supported by Codeless, and that one is this repeat while. Let me connect it here, and then this I will disable just so it doesn't pollute our output. So repeat while is going to be a loop that continues until or while certain condition is true, or the opposite would be is the until, so until certain condition is met. Okay, so this can be used easily to create an infinite loop for us. So for instance, an example of an infinite loop will be if you put in here, if you go into logic and you put true, then anything inside will run infinitely because this true always remains as true. The only way to get out of that loop would be using this breakout block. Generally, it is not a good practice to create those infinite loops. Sometimes they're necessary. So, but whenever you create an infinite loop, always watch out for basically a necessity to create a condition with a loop where you break out of that loop. What would be a good example of a loop that contains this repeat while? Here's a basic example. Let's create a new variable and let's call that variable done. We will initialize this variable to false because it's not done yet. False. And then in here we will repeat while not done. So in here in the logic we'll use the not block and then connect the done variable. In fact, it reads very well. So repeat while not done, okay? And inside of this loop, we can just create yet another variable. Let's say this variable, and in fact, we already have variable I, okay? So we can just basically create some sort of iterator where just this number is growing, and what it's gonna go like this, change I by one, so I is going to be incremented by one every single time, okay? And let's say as soon as I hits certain number, we want to say, okay, we're done. And in this case, we add the logic, if I equals, let's say, 50, So when I equals 50, in fact, that needs to go inside of the loop. What we want to do is we want to set the variable done as true. I took a wrong block. What we want to do is this one. Set done to true. So here's what happens here. We set done to false because we're just starting, we're not done yet. Then we're entering the loop and we're executing this loop while done is false. As soon as done is true, it will stop, okay? Because the loop will continue so long that this value that is feeds into the loop is true, okay? And it's gonna be true with the not operator as long as done is false. There is going to be a simpler way to do it. I'll show you in a second. We enter this loop and we increment I by 1. Then we check if I is 50. If it is, then we set done to true. When it's 1, it's not 50, then it continues and it basically becomes 2, 3, 4, and so on. Because with every new step of the loop, this increments I by 1. As soon as I hits 50, we say, okay, done. Done is now true. It goes to the beginning of the loop. Done is now true, with a not it becomes false, and then repeat loop ends. And in here, just to provide a little bit more visual feedback, if we use the print block, which will be right here, we can print the value of I, just so to get, once again, some visual feedback. And let's run this page. There you go. So, as you can see, we got I starting from 1 all the way to 50, and then the loop stopped. What would be a simpler way to do it without this not operator? Well, this is where until comes from, okay? So with this until, we can just connect done. So basically, while and until, they are the opposites of each other. While accepts value of true, until accepts value of false. So basically, with while, the loop will continue while the parameter is true. With until, the loop will continue while this parameter is false. The rest is going to be exactly the same. Let's run it. And as you can see, it's exactly the same result. And there you have it. Three different versions of loops. Once again, fixed number of executions where you specify how many. Then a range where you go from one value to another value, incrementing it by some other step, and then while and until loops. That's it, three of them. And with this, you can program any kind of repetition as you see fit. Inside of the loops, you can call other functions, you can do pretty much anything and everything that you have learned so far and everything that you will learn in the future. So loops, they contain just regular logic that is being repeated over and over again. That's it. Thank you for watching, guys. Again, if you have any questions or comments, please let us know. Just write up your question or provide any feedback. We'll be more than happy to answer. Again, thanks for watching. And as always, happy Codeless coding.